Saturn and Pisces. And so we know that Pisces don't like to mess with Saturn because it's materialistic and it's practical. It's because we know that Pisces is the one that like to fantasize and visualize and dream. And so Pisces has this energy, this superpower, that it's hard for them to use it in a practical sense. And so they can stay living in their minds, in their imaginary souls or minds. And so what Saturn would do, Saturn would teach Pisces to use his powers and help Pisces to use his powers by Pisces going through things that deals with disappointment and emotional messes going on, and by Pisces taking losses. So Saturn will help them. It will teach them through all these losses, through all these disappointments, through all this harshness, through everything that a Pisces go through, is actually teaching them a lesson. Anything that a Pisces don't like is working for somebody, or working any position that's structured, or in any organization, because the Pisces like to do their own thing. And so what Saturn would do, it would teach them that to work in a structure environment or under someone, it would teach them to do that, but also it would teach them that, give them that wisdom that when they do that, they don't have to be there forever. It's only until they continue to grow into their own powers, then they could be the spiritual healers and the filmmakers and the one who has the creative powers, who's creating. And so the Pisces makes good actors and stuff like that. They'll come to their true powers if they discipline themselves. And that discipline deals with their lessons in life, that deals with working. So Pisces, you have to work. You got to put in some work. You can't be so lazy because you don't want to do this. You need to pay the bills. I know that you're so spiritual and money don't faze you, but you got to work in this society to make it. And so long as you work, you will see, and you as you work, you will create yourself and become stronger until you have your own job. And your own job will be something that's spiritual and divine. But so it will teach you to come out of that in practical realm and to become practical. It will teach you to not to just fantasize, but to use that fantasy or that imagination and put it into use and to manifest. It will teach you this. This is what Saturn trying to do. And this, I think this is a very good placement, because with Saturn here, Pisces just ain't going to just be the one that just fantasize and that's it. They're going to manifest what they fantasize, because Saturn going to teach them how to do this. Pisces' greatest challenge is following through on something. But Saturn will get them the drive to be persistent. It will get them the strength to manifest and to carry anything out. And also, it will help them to be more organized and also recognize their gifts and their talents. So Saturn will discipline them where they can recognize their gift and their talents, their empath ability, because they're natural empaths. And Pisces has all-around psychic ability. So Saturn will teach them to be that psychic. Out of all placement, this is one of the best, I say the best placement for a Pisces, because it helps them to be more organized and more structured. It helps them to be more stable through what they go through. Pisces need it. They down here in the earthly plane with the spiritual realm, but they're not being practical or realistic to be able to relate to this world. So they need this placement. Even though some would say this is a difficult placement, but it's needed. Because at the end of the day, once they discipline themselves, guess what? They can't be touched. And nobody can touch this placement, which is Saturn and Pisces, because they'd be the great psychics, the great healers, the great philosophers, the great artists, everything. You know they like the wine. Pisces like the wine. And they like to play the victim game and all that there. They won't be doing none of that once they master themselves. They'll be strong. Won't just come up with an idea and look past it and move on. or come up with an idea and say, I'm going to do this. No. Saturn getting an ability to manifest this. Pisces will definitely become that sage, that master healer, the one who's the master psychic, the master spiritual teacher, the master at whatever. Because Pisces is the old soul. So once they tap into who they are, and Saturn help gives them that discipline to be practical with it and put it into real life form, they become the magical, like the magical wand. They can visualize it, and now it exists. All they do, visualize it, and now it's magical. And so they'll be teaching philosophy, writing, spiritual occult, or occult knowledge. They'll be teaching metaphysics. They'll be teaching astrology, numerology. They'll be teaching anything that deals with the public and the media. Because if they was afraid to be in the media, Saturn helped them to be in the media after some years and years. Sooner or later, Pisces is going to come up out of that shell through the experience and become stronger, because Saturn makes it more stronger through the suffering and pain. And they're going to be able to be in that media and be the best in the media, who bring astrology, numerology, knowledge, spiritual knowledge and wisdom, and also healing of all kinds through the media. And also use their creativity ability, which is music, arts, whatever type of music that they do or that they listen to, they'll bring that into life. Pisces is definitely here to help people reach their higher self and to put the light into others and share their compassion and love to others. Well, a Pisces can sympathize with others and also empathetic towards others. So Pisces is here to help people to understand their emotions. Pisces is here to help people on every level as a therapist. So they are the therapist energy. Well, a therapy means healing of all kinds. So therapy comes in many forms, massages and things of that nature. Pisces can do all type of healing, from touching, from meditation. And so a Pisces will need to meditate. So this part of their discipline, meditation, directing their energy. So as they get disciplined, they'll understand all this. And so with this placement, you one of the best as the healer. You have that superpower. So anybody who has that superpowers, wow, as the healer, and also not only to heal others, but to heal yourself. Wow, this is just so powerful. Now, as I can't bring this light, it gets no realer than this. I shake.